என்ன கிச்சு கிச்சா?
இல்ல சார், ரெண்டு நாளா தொண்டை கட்டி இருக்கு சார்.
ஓகே, ரெடி, ஸ்டார்ட்மா.
குட் மார்னிங் எவ்ரிவன், அண்ட் டுடே வில் சி அபவுட் ஃபிபனாசி ஹீப். இட் இஸ் ஒன் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஹீப். தே ஆர் டூ டைப்ஸ், பைனோமியல் ஹீப் அண்ட் ஃபிபனாசி ஹீப். இன் திஸ் ஃபிபனாசி ஹீப் ஆல் தி is a, it is a collection of trees with minimum heap or maxi property. It has both minimum heap and maxi heap property like binomial heap. In this Fibonacci heap, trees can have a different kinds of shape. It is not that as a binomial heap that one node should have, the root node should have only two children or like that. Here it can have every any kind of shape, and it can take it can have the same degree also. If in this example you can see that 23, the node 23 and the node 7, it has the same degree and it doesn't have any children. But in binomial heap there is a condition that it must have two children, and there must not be any same degree. So in Fibonacci heap maintains a pointer to minimum value. It always maintains a pointer to minimum value, which means that in this example, 3 is the root node, which means 3 has the minimum, I mean that node has the minimum value key of 3. This will be the minimum value pointer. So all the tree nodes are connected using the main advantage of this Fibonacci heap is that all the nodes are connected in a circular doubly linked list, so all of them can be accessed using a single min pointer. Because it is using a doubly linked list of circular type, so it can have only one pointer, that is the minimum pointer, where it is given here. This minimum pointer is enough to maintain, because in doubly linked list, if it is in a circular condition, in this case every node can be, the new coming elements or new coming nodes can be added as the root element, so it can be added in front of the root. So in this type, since it is doubly linked list, it can have only one pointer. But in this Fibonacci heap, it will always maintain a pointer for the minimum value, which means a 3. 3 is always root in this Fibonacci heap structure. Now we'll see various operations. First, creation, insertion, finding of minimum key, union, and how to extract the minimum key. And extracting the minimum key is nothing but the minimum element, the node which has the minimum number of value. It is called, it is the minimum key. Then how to decrease the key, and what is deletion process. We'll see all these. In the creation process, the Fibonacci heap is created in this format. The empty heap is created, which means here where n of h is equal to 0, and the minimum value, because it is always while creation, the Fibonacci heap is always a empty heap which contains no value, so the minimum value is nil. And then the cost of this make Fibonacci heap is always of O one times. And then first we'll see the insert process. There is three cases in insert process. There is one case in insert process where it is very simple. Create a new tree where if you wanted to add a new element, you will just add the element near to that of the minimum pointer. But in the circular linked list, we know that all the elements are added to the before, which means it will be the root pointer. In before the root pointer, you can add all the elements. So in this case, you need not check for the value or where you wanted to, in the it will be a children or it will be a parent, like that and all. Simply you will just add the element in front of the minimum value pointer, where the minimum value pointer nodes. So you have to, after adding, if insertion of 21, if I insert 21, you will just simply add it like this near the, you will simply add it near the minimum pointer, where if then we have to check the update minimum pointer. If I wanted to add element 2, if I wanted to add element 2, then I will add it next to the minimum pointer. And after adding to the minimum pointer, next to the minimum pointer, we'll have to update the minimum pointer. If in this case, after adding 2, if we add 2, that 2 will be the minimum value key. So at that time, this min pointer will come to the value where we have inserted. So in after that, the minimum pointer value will be 2. That's all. This is the insertion process, which is very easier. And then union. Union is also a very simple process. In this case, what you have to, since they follow a circular doubly linked list, we can just simply, what we'll do this, we'll simply will connect this two. 17 and 7 will connect this to, this is called a union process in this. See, simply will, since it is doubly linked list and it is circular, which means it is circular, so we can add the elements simply directly connected to 17 and 7. So always the cost is O of 1, which means that there is nothing extra process is carried out to find, it is not a time consumption also. Simply you will add the two, H1 H dash is 1, 3 and H double dash is 1, 3. So simply you will add both, that's all. And then we'll see of deletion now. So first deleting the min value after deleted. If we know that in this example, 3 is the minimum value key, which it is also a minimum key value pointer. First, if you wanted to delete the minimum, then delete min and concatenate its children into root list. First, if you want to delete 3, the next process what you have to do is the nodes which is the children of the 3, that is 18, 52 and 41, all these 3 nodes will be added to the root list. I'll tell you one thing, there is a difference in the color. You see that 18 is of one color and 52 is of one color, which means this denotes that 18 is a marked node, which means the 18 have lost one children. It is the reason that it has lost one child. And if you come to 52, 41, 44, all other purple color nodes, you see that in this case, it is not marked, which means that it has not lost any child. So concatenate, first what we have to do it, delete the min. If you want to delete the min, you have to remove the node 3 and then you have to add all the other children, all the 18, 52 and 41 to the root. So this is the case. So we have deleted this 3 and what happens is the 18, 52 and 41 will come to the root. So then what we have to do is the 7 will be the min pointer. 7 is always, I mean, you know that 3 is a min pointer here. Once it is done, once the 18, 52 and 47 is done, in this value 3 is gone now. So the next minimum pointer is 7. So we have to bring that root, this 7, and then this will be this will be the min pointer and also the current pointer. Then see the next one, consolidate root so that no two roots have same degree. In while the deletion process, the node, but the structure can have two same degree process. But when you do a deletion of min, if you wanted to delete the min pointer, then you have to check this condition. You have to make the tree to this kind. So then next we'll start the how to delete it. See, first the deletion is done and the 18, 52 and 41 has been taken to the root. Now the minimum pointer is 7 and if there is one more pointer called current, from we'll start from the left corner of the tree. First minimum pointer and then it is also the current pointer. First what we have to do, 7 and 30. For this process we will have a buffer. Since we will count the trees, here the degree is 0 and 1. It has 1 degree. Here 0, 1 and 2. So it in this has 2 degree. That this is 0, 0, then this is 0, 1, 1, 0, and this is 0, 1, 1. Here, since it is 0, 1, and 2, we'll take the buffer till 3. 0, 1, 2, and 3. So, how many degrees are there? In that value, we'll take plus 1, which is, they will have the buffer of 3. Now, we'll start the deletion of min, the process, which means the second condition is that there no two nodes must have the same degree. So, now first, 7 and 30. First, the current pointer is on 7. So, we'll take this 7. And 7, 30, it has 1 degree. So we'll have this, we'll move this to the 1. So we'll add this element to the 1 degree of 1. Then if you come to the next one, it has 2. So then we'll add this to the 2. And then next we've come to the 23, it is of 0 degree. So we'll add it in the 0. Then the current pointer will move. I'm sorry. Current pointer will move and then it will be on 17 and this 17. Now there is a clash because 23 and 17 has the same degree. In this case, what we have to do is we have to have the 17 in that place because it is the minimum. 17 in this place is the minimum. So what we have to do is we have to bring this 23 down as the child of this 17. So now if you see that 17 is the minimum value. In this heap, the minimum value will be always on the top and the maximum value will come down as the child. And if there are many number of nodes, it is always added to the first, it is added to the left of the root. Now the 17 is here and 23 is added to the left of the root. Now now we have to check the current degree again. It is of 1, and we know that there is something in the 1 already, but that is 7 and 30 is already there. So now what we have to do is 7 is the minimum. I told you that the minimum value will be on the root. So here the 7 comes to the root and 30 is its child. And what I said is all the new element which we are adding is always added to the left of the root. So same like that, 17, and then comes the 23 of that 17 child. And then now the current value, now if we check that it has 2, and now we'll move to, it has 2, and now again if you check the degree, it even this has 2 and this has 2. So what we have to do is again check this. Since the 7 is a small, we'll have the 7 on the root as well. And what we'll do is we'll bring this 22 as another left, because I told you that we have to add it in the left. So it is not that it when in the binomial heap, we know that it should follow the binomial structure that it has only 2 children. But in the Fibonacci heap, it has no condition that it should have only 2 or 3 children. So here what we'll do is we'll bring this 24 to the as the another children for the node 7. And now if you check the degree, it is of 3. So it will be added to the 3. Then the current element is moved. The current pointer is moved to the 18. Now 18 and 39, which is of degree 1, it will be moved to the buffer 1. And then if you take 52, then it will move to the buffer 0. And if it is 2, buffer 1. Again, there is a clash here. 18, 39, 41, 44 of same degree. What do we have to do? We know that 18 will be in the same place. Remove the current pointer to 41. 18 will be in the root place. So what we'll do is 41 will be added to the root. You know that 18 will come to the position of the current value, where the 41 is the position where the pointer is there. In this case, what will happen is 18 will come to the current position, and it is in the root always because it is the minimum value. Then the 41, what happens is it will come down as the left root, left of the root node. And now this is the process. Now we know that all the degrees have different degrees here. 7, for the 7, you take the node, it will have 3 degree. If for 52, it is 0, it's because it has no child. And the next one, we know that it is of degree 1 and 2. So now we know that this is the deletion structure. You have to delete the minimum pointer value with this process. So deletion is done. The next process will have to decrease a key. Okay, decreasing a key. Decrease a key of element of X to K, which means if we take an element, we'll take an element called 50, we'll take an element called 30. If you want to decrease this element by different values, it may be 5 or 4 or 6, or it may be of 35 or 40, there is different condition if you have the greater value, and then there is a different condition if you have a smaller than this 30. So there is of 3 cases in this delay, in the decreasing of the key. First one, case 0. Minimum heap property are not violated. The property is that I told you already that the minimum value will be at the top, and as the greater value comes, it will be added as the root of that. In the root of that node. Then first we're decreasing. First we'll see how the process starts. First, if we wanted to decrease 46 to 45, in this place there is a value called 46, and I have changed it to 45. In this, when I make correction in this, there is no, the property is not violated, because 24 is always a minimum value than 45, and 72 is greater than 45, though the property is not violated. And we have to change the heap min pointer if necessary. Now, if I wanted to add 2, what happens? The 2 will come as a root, because always I told you that the minimum value will always be on the root. Then if I want to add 2, I'll add it near the minimum pointer 2, and I have to change this min pointer, because now the new coming root, the 2 will be the minimum pointer, because it has the low minimum value. So first case is that if I want to change anything, we should always keep in mind that the property is not violated. And then the next condition is the parent of X is unmarked. I told you that marked and unmarked, the difference of it. Then if the parent of X is marked, so what I'm doing is I'm going to change this 45 to 15. So if I change this element 45 to 15, now the property is violated. You know that I told you that if the 15 is in the above and 24 is below, then we need not do any changes because the root element 7 is always smaller. Now here the violation happens because 24 is greater than 15. So what we have to do is we have to decrease. See, I will read this case one by one. Decrease key to x to k. What we have done is we have changed the 45 to 15. Then what we have, the next step to be followed is cutoff link between x and its parent. So this we have changed. So this is the x. What we have to do is we have to cut off this link between 15 and 24, which means for the 15, 24 is the parent. So I've cut off the parent and marked the parent. Because I've marked the parent, because I told you that when the node is marked, it is that it has lost one or two children. So here it is lost one children. So I'm bringing it, as soon as I cut this node, I bring this to the root, and this 24 is marked. And then add tree rooted at x to root list and updating heap. Now what I did is I've brought the 15 to the root, and now the minimum heap pointer is checked. Because it is 15, no problem, that 7 will be always in the minimum because it has the minimum value. Then next case, for the second case, I'll tell you. Now the second case is that decrease the key to x to the value. So here we are decreasing 35 to 5. In this case, we are decreasing 35 to here it is, the node is here, 35 to 5. If I decrease, the property is violated because I told you that 26 is greater than 5. When the property is violated, then what the same condition, cut off the link between x and its parent x. The second case is that if the parent is marked, where the child which I'm decreasing, which has a parent, that the parent is marked. See, check this condition. In the before condition, the parent is not marked. We are just want to decrease the value, but the property is violated. In this case, the parent is marked. What we have to do is decrease the key x to the k. What we have to change is 35 to 5. And what I told you is this 35 to 5, I change, I should bring it to the root. I've brought it to the root. Then cut off the link x and parents and add it to the root list. That I've done it. I've added to the root list. Now the parent is marked. We know that when the parent is marked, we have to check on to the next step. This is the step. Cut off link between the parent of x. This is the parent now. This link and the parent of parent x, which is for this 26, what is the parent? 24 is the parent, and it is also marked. So the what we have to do is we have to cut this link as well. We have to cut this link and we have to add this 26 to 88. And then we have to remove it. It is unmarked. And then if the 24, if I take in this condition, when 24 is not marked, what we have to do is after taking this 26 and 88 to the root, we have to mark this 24. But the 24 is, this 24 is already marked. So what we have to do, the parent of p of x is marked and cut off the parent unmarked. And we have to repeat this process. What we have to do is, I told you, we have to take this parent and also the parent of parent. So in this case, what we have to do, we have to take this 24 and we have to put it down. And if this 24 has any parent, which means it is not root, we should not compare it with root, it has any parent, what we have to do, we have to mark it and we have to continue the process until all the elements are taken to the root. Okay, now what we have done is we have removed 24 from this root, we have cut off this link and we have brought this 24 to this place. Thank you. This is the deletion process that we have done, and decreasing of the key, and the union process, nothing but we will merge simply because it is doubly linked list, circular doubly linked list. And then we have done the creation. How the creation is nothing but it is already the first, the creation is that it has the zero, which has no element, and it is an empty heap. Next, extraction of minimum key. I told you that it is simple way that the minimum value in the root will be always called as the root value, and it is the minimum value key. And then these are all the operations done where we can do in the Fibonacci heap, and it is carried out one by one, and we have seen everything. And insertion is also done where always it is added to the near the minimum pointer. And the if you wanted to delete a element, first you have to decrease it and then you have to delete it. Please remember this. Once we have to delete, if you want to delete an element, first we have to decrease the key And then you have to continue with the deletion process. But in this steps, we have found that we have seen the deletion first and then minimum key, you have to decrease a key. So always when you want to delete it, we have to decrease the key first. That decrease is nothing but you have to change some conversions. You have to, I've seen that you have the node is marked or not. All the three cases we have seen, you have to decrease it and then you have to delete it. Thank you.